That's a rarity throughout the history of anime releases for a Japanese version, the, you know, the subtitle, the Japanese audio, to actually get quite a bit of hate. Honestly, for the most part, usually the fans really are like gung-ho about it, like, yeah, you know, the voice is on par because it's foreign to us, and honestly, it sounds more interesting than the language that we're usually accustomed to. Black Clover's the exception. Japanese version, the one glaring problem thus far, with 6 episodes, if I'm not mistaken, that are out as of the recording of this video. People can't stand the Japanese version of the main character Asta's voice. They just cannot stand the screaming, the constant yelling, and it gets annoying. And I've said it in multiple videos now that it's annoying. Now, they've tried to make a joke out of it in the series, like, oh my gosh, you're so annoying, shut up, this and that. And honestly, it's different than, like, okay, you go to a series like Full Metal Alchemist, right? Series like Full Metal Alchemist, you know, the short jokes with Ed, it's funny, short, blah, blah, blah. The difference is, it sometimes does get a little bit annoying with the Japanese version, and it's a rare instance where fans unite to unify and say that an English dub is actually the way to go. Because, you know, there's a lot of Japanese purists that they just want the subtitled way. But honestly, I have to tell you guys, I experienced the English dub of Black Clover, which as of the recording of this video, if I'm not mistaken, there are 3 episodes out English dub, so we're only a few episodes behind the Japanese. You go back 10 or 15 years, we was 15 years behind, you know what I'm saying? So we're about 3 episodes behind in the English dub, but I have to tell you guys that honestly, from the moment I heard it, and you could check my Twitter, no bullshit, I was like, yo, I can't believe it right now. Funimation, hallelujah, you guys solved a very big issue and honestly made it that Black Clover, when it comes to this series in particular, English dub is the way to go. That glaring problem of the main character Asta, kind of, you know, his voice just being ear aching, is gone in the English version. The voice that they picked, it suits it because, yes, it's still supposed to be, you know, story-wise that Asta is a bit annoying and he's loud and it's like, yo, shut up and calm down a little bit. But it's not like the way the Japanese does it where it's like, honestly, it really gets a little bit annoying. It's like, yo, I want to enjoy this series, but it gets a little overbearing. With the English version that Funimation has released, again, 3 episodes as of the recording of this video, it's just like, yes, I can enjoy Black Clover. I can sit back and indulge in it. And it's good. It's really good. There's very few instances where I can 100% wholeheartedly say I go with dub over sub. Yu Yu Hakusho is one of those series that no matter what you tell me, I'm going English dub. Obviously, Dragon Ball Z, even though with Dragon Ball Super, watching it weekly, I've gotten accustomed to the Japanese version and I really enjoy it and I, you know, I'm a big fan of it. But most people, especially the common fan, they're going to say, give me that English dub, boy. You know what I'm saying? Full Metal Alchemist, another one. We love our dub of Full Metal. There's quite a few series, and honestly, I gotta add Black Clover to the list of dub over sub all the way. You have to experience it for yourself. This video is indeed sponsored by Funimation. I gotta be upfront with you guys, but it's always a perfect match, and I never do anything sponsored that I don't believe in, and that isn't completely tied into what this is all about for Neverworld. You know what I'm saying? This is an anime manga based channel. I was gonna talk to you guys about the Black Clover dub at some given point anyway. They presented me an opportunity to talk to you guys about it, give my opinion on it, and I stick with my very same opinion that I had when I very first finished that first episode. What was it, about a week or two back? I loved it. I think the dub is so much better than Japanese. If you want to check it out, bam, I promoted this before. I got a link in the description below to Funimation Now. They again have the 3 episodes that are out as of the recording of this video, which I've said that like multiple times, but yeah, they have it there. You get a 2-week free trial if you use the code that I got in the description below, and you can experience it and see for yourself whether or not you want to go English dub or sub. Again, I highly recommend. I've watched a lot of anime, you know what I'm saying? I've watched a lot of anime, and I can tell you the big problem that Black Clover is having right now is gone in the English version. Did a phenomenal job with the casting, honestly, and so far I'm like, yeah, the only problem is if you're impatient like me, which I'm impatient, I want my shit now, you might want to still stick with the Japanese because there are a few episodes ahead. But if you really can't stand Asta's voice, English dub, link in the description below. You can go check it out for yourself and see what the hype is all about, because a lot of people are actually feeling the same way, which is a rarity. You know, people how they are, like, nah, Japanese all the way. But no, people feel the same way as me, and that's a great thing, because English dub is one of the best things too, which I'm not one of those people, I'm too lazy to read. No, I watch Japanese up and down the block, you know what I'm saying? But I love me an English dub where I could just sit back, relax, multitask. Maybe I want to play a little bit of, I don't know, mobile Dokkan game, you know, Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle, and watch my anime at the same time. Now, with that being said, that portion of the video is over. I wanted to talk just briefly about the latest couple episodes of Black Clover that are out in Japanese, episodes 5 and 6. I didn't talk about last week's episode, and this week's episode came out today. Honestly, Black Clover right now is getting more into what I talked about in my very first impression video of this, where it's feeling very fairy tale-ish. Like, okay, last week's episode, we got to see where Asta was going, if he was going to become a Magic Knight. He got accepted. He's with the Black Bulls, which I've been hyping about them, and I was really excited to finally see them. And then this week's episode, we get to see the Black Bulls, and it really gave me some fairy tale vibe. You know, when you go and you first meet the guild, and they're a rowdy bunch. But honestly, I can say wholeheartedly that this guild, or this group, this Magic Knight group, they're a little bit more grittier. I like these characters a lot. Like, you got Magna, you got Finral, you have Locke, you have Vanessa Enoteca. Oh my gosh, that's my type of gal. You know what I'm saying? She's puking up magic, bro. Like, give me that Vanessa Enoteca. So with episode 6, we got introduced to the Black Bulls, and we had a little bit of them messing around with Asta, and it really felt like fairy tale. But honestly, even going towards the beginning of fairy tale, which people will say that, hey, at the beginning, fairy tale wasn't as bad. I even prefer this over the beginning of fairy tale. And when we first got introduced to the fairy tale guild, these guys, like, you know, between Yami, which as we go along, you will see why I've been hyping up Yami. Such a beast ass character. You got Yami in there too, the captain of this Magic Knight group, the Black Bulls. And it was a really cool introduction. Art and animation, I am surprised. Studio Perrier are doing two things that I did not expect with Black Clover. One, art and animation has been very consistently gorgeous. Like, I believe that they believe in Black Clover very heavily. I mean, for crying out loud, when it came out, the promotions were saying the new king of shonen is here, right? So I think they really believe wholeheartedly in this, and they're getting like their best staff members, but also I think they're outsourcing it to some very talented staff, because episodes 5 and 6, they just looked amazing. When Asta was swinging his sword and hitting Magna's fucking fire magic, I was like, why does this look so good? But another thing that I've noticed yet again with these recent 6 episodes, the first 6 episodes thus far, is the pacing. Honestly, they really are going at a very slow pace, and it's been 100% confirmed that we are getting 51 episodes of Black Clover. I don't know if it's going to be consecutive. I'm imagining it's going to be consecutive, which is why they're doing the pacing this way, where it's kind of slow paced, but Black Clover, the manga, is the exact opposite. The manga is ridiculously fast-paced, and you lose out on a lot of the context, which episodes 5 and 6 really get. You get to experience more moments with these characters and get to really learn them. Like, when I read the manga of this, honestly, it took me a long time to remember some of these characters, especially the Black Bulls. You watch the anime, it's like, oh, this Magna guy, oh, Vanessa. And then, of course, at the end, you get the introduction to that chick that we've seen at the entrance exams to try to become a Magic Knight or whatever. I believe her name, I don't know if it's been spoiled or not, but spoiler alert, it's just a fucking name. Her name is Noelle, and you've seen her talking to Silva from one of those really high royal people, whatever, and she has a connection to him, but she's apparently a part of the Black Bulls, and I'm really excited to see more of them unraveling her throughout the series. Episodes 5 and 6 have been really nice introductions, a little bit slow, you could argue, whatever, but so far, it's like doing the same thing that I've said from the very beginning of Black Clover. Like, there's a lot of similar elements that you've seen time and time again. I mean, Asta, for crying out loud, says the same shit, just in his own way of what Naruto said, you know what I'm saying? Naruto, my ninja way. Asta, this is my magic, you know what I'm saying? So it's very, very similar. And then, like I said, it felt straight up like the fairy tale vibe of the guild. You got Vanessa as pretty much Kana, you know, the drunk hottie and shit like that. So it gave me those vibes, but it's just really enjoyable and chill. And I'll say one more thing, and I need to clarify this. I need to really clarify this, because on Twitter, people just did not understand what I was saying, and they were like, you're wrong. And no, I'm not wrong, because my opinion, or what I'm about to tell you guys, is my experience and my enjoyment. Nothing to do with quality, which I'll quickly address it as well. With these first 6 episodes of Black Clover, in comparison to pretty much its competitor, like, you know, we have 2 series right now that, no matter what you say, they're competitors to be the next big shonen, you know, next big 3, so to speak, or whatever, My Hero Academia, my enjoyment, my experience of enjoyment enjoying, not quality, which we'll address in a second, just me having a good time, I will say I'm enjoying the first 6 episodes of Black Clover more than I enjoyed the first 6 episodes of season 1 of My Hero Academia. My enjoyment. I'm not saying it's better or anything like that. I'm saying I am enjoying it. I'm liking where it's going. And maybe it's also due to my own bias of I really like those medieval settings and shit like that. I really enjoy that. So I gotta say that these first 6 episodes in general, I'm having a really fucking blast. I'm really enjoying what they're doing with Black Clover. Now, to quickly address quality, I will tell you right now, My Hero Academia is better than Black Clover quality-wise, and I'm speaking from an objective standpoint. I think the writing is way more solid. Yeah, it does have some similarities to other shonen, but it very quickly breaks away and does its own thing. Black Clover, it's just really enjoyable to me, though. So that's where you can say, hey, something is better, but I enjoy the inferior thing just because it gives me something different that I really enjoy. There's nothing wrong with that, and I needed to clarify that because I wanted to state my opinion that I'm having a great time with Black Clover more than I did with the first season. Now, second season of My Hero Academia, different ballgame. Different ballgame. I had an amazing time, and it was very enjoyable, but quality-wise, My Hero Academia over Black Clover. Enjoyment as of right now, I'm enjoying Black Clover more than I enjoyed the first 6 of My Hero Academia. I'm not trying to sell it to you. I'm just being honest. Kind of curious what you guys think. For starters, if you've seen the English dub of Black Clover, what do you think of it? Do you think that it truly solves the problem? Is that truly the way to go with this series because of Asta's annoying Japanese voice? And if you haven't seen it, are you going to check it out? Again, link in the description below. Funimation now, 2 weeks free. You get to experience it. And maybe you might want to stick with the dub because it's a damn good dub. We're in a day and age where it's a rarity where you get bad dubs, English dubs, and this is a better product than the Japanese version. Also, what do you think about episodes 5 and 6 of Black Clover thus far? Did you get them fairy tale vibes when you met the Black Bulls? And if you watch My Hero Academia, which one have you enjoyed more? The first 6 of My Hero Academia season 1 or the first 6 of this? And which one do you think is better? I know I shouldn't be doing these comparison things, but let's be honest, my comment section is fucking cancer. Everybody talks about this is better than that and that and that. So fuck it, why not? Let's indulge. What do you think? Which one's better? Which one you enjoyed more? Your overall thoughts of all this? Just wanted to do a big Black Clover video. Again, this video is sponsored by Funimation, which it's a great fit. I wanted to talk and praise Black Clover's dub anyways. Why not? But that's all I have for this one, though. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you liked anything I had to say or enjoyed the video, drop me a like. I'd greatly appreciate it. And if you want more from me, make sure to subscribe. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and do a little stalking on my Facebook to get more when the video ends. I'm Fnebel World, and as always, people, bow! Have an awesome day.